Legal stakeholders and the East African Law Society are meeting in Kampala to analyze the progress towards standardization and ensure that the development of the East African legal and regulatory framework for legal training, certification and practice within the region is well conducted.
That if you are offering law faculty education in Uganda, the same should be in Kenya, the same should be in Tanzania, the same should be in Rwanda and Burundi. So that we do not have quack lawyers, we do not have half-baked lawyers across the region. Sometimes a lawyer may be removed from the role in Kampala. Then he runs to start and open a practice in Kenya, and nobody knows. So we are therefore trying to monitor and make sure that such a thing does not happen. So if you have been removed from the role, you are no longer a practitioner in Kenya, then you can therefore not come and practice in Uganda. So we are building a serious database. We will track all the lawyers in East Africa and make sure that the services that they offer to the members of the public is qualitative and competent and beyond any question.
While officiating at the meeting, Eria Kategaya, the minister in charge of East African Affairs, said the discussion is timely, strategic and is in line with the Treaty for the Establishment of the East African Community. He, however, advised that the East African Law Society should work towards integrating and harmonizing the two existing legal regimes in the region.
If they are going to have cross-border practices, somebody from Burundi to come and practice in Uganda would be difficult. Or Ugandan lawyers to go and practice in Burundi, it would be difficult when there are two different systems. So my suggestion was that, I don't know whether they have capacity, but we should find a way, or find if you can have a common position. The whole region. For example, in Rwanda, they are trying to marry the both, what they call common law and the civil law.
The East African Law Society also wants to be included in the formulation of laws at the regional level. The organization's vice president says they are being sidelined and some flaws have been registered.
Apparently, a lot of EEC organs do not consult the East African Law Society. All the lawyers across the region, when they come up with these laws, a number of times these laws are drafted with a lot of flaws, a lot of problems. And we are saying that if we were involved right from the beginning, those problems will be avoided.
Michael Baleke, NTV.